Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfat. His Royal Highness Crown Prince and Prime Minister Bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa stressed the importance of continuing to strictly adhere to all precautionary measures by limiting gatherings to members of the same household or close social circle and utilizing outdoor open spaces rather than closed places. The public reminder takes place at a time when significant COVID-19 developments in a number of countries are being closely monitored by the National Medical Task Force for combating the coronavirus. His Royal Highness Crown Prince and Prime Minister emphasized the importance of adhering to precautionary measures issued by the National Medical Task Force for combating the coronavirus, adding that the virus is still present and poses a risk to the community. Therefore, complacency must be avoided to protect the community and support frontliners in achieving their targets. His Royal Highness stressed that the success of the Kingdom's national efforts to combat COVID-19 requires continued community awareness and collective national responsibility to preserve the health and safety of all. In this regard, His Royal Highness noted that with the support of all, the goals of the Kingdom's national COVID-19 response will be fulfilled. His Royal Highness concluded by highlighting the immense efforts of the Kingdom's frontliners in combating COVID-19 and protecting the community, emphasizing the importance of a united and responsible community to safeguard the health of the Kingdom's citizens and residents. His Royal Highness Crown Prince and Prime Minister Bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa met and received a collection of poems titled Al-Hamadiyat from Bahraini poet Muhammad Hadi Al-Halwachi at Rufa Palace. His Royal Highness Crown Prince highlighted the importance of poetry to cultural heritage and its historic role promoting social values that contributed to the consolidation of Arab and national identities. In this regard, His Royal Highness noted His Majesty the King's continued support to the preservation of the Kingdom's cultural heritage. His Royal Highness emphasized the Kingdom's commitment to preserving its Arab heritage whilst building bridges between different societies as a means of enhancing Bahrain's global standing. His Royal Highness praised Al-Halwachi for his efforts compiling the poems, with several written in praise of His Majesty the King. He wished him success in his upcoming poetic work.
سلمانا تحية عبقت وردا وريحانا وقل له عن لسان الشعر مألوكة إن الحبيب حبيب كيفما كان إن صد أو رد أو إن جاد مكرمة سيانة في القلب والميزان سيانة ما كنت بدعا وما كان القصيد سوى رسالة صدتها حبا وقربانا جاءت مهنئة بالحب ناطشة لم تدخر أبدا في الشعر أوزانا يا قرة العين للبحرين قاطبة يا شبل من شاد بالأمجاد بنيانا يا ابن المليك الذي لولا محبته ما قلت بيتا ولا غنيت ألحانا تحية من صميم القلب صادقة سطرت فيها معاني الحب ألوانا بثثت فيها فنون الشعر مقتدرا كأنه لؤلؤ قد حف عقيانا وما ونيت وما كانت لتعجزني قصائد بل أرى في الحرف إذعانا آتي القصيد وقد جفت منابعه فيرجع الشعر مما قلتم الآن في البدء كانت يد بيضاء قد سلفت منكم وأذكرها شكرا وعرفانا وكان منكم من التقدير ما عجزت عنه الحروف وإن حاولت تبيانا إني رأيت الندى والجود مكتملا لما رأيت بذاك اليوم سلمانا إني رأيت الندى والجود مكتملا لما رأيت بذاك اليوم سلمانا سلمان جيل من الآمال مبتعثا بالحب حلما وبالأحلام عمرانا أحيا بهمته الآمال فانطلقت في إثر دعوته تزداد إيمانا وما مقالي إلا كلمة صدقت في الحب قد اتخذت في الشعر ميدانا حبي لكم من هوى البحرين منبعه وقد لهجت به سرا وإعلانا وحب أهلي وأرضي قد لبست به يوم التفاخر بين الناس تيجانا. يا حبذا وطن البحرين من وطن، وحبذا ساكن البحرين من كان. دار بها ثبتت للمجد مفخرة، وأسست من نعيم الحب أركانا. دار بها حمد ضاءت بطلعته ربوعها، فاعتلت في المجد كيوانا. أحيا بحكمته آمال أمته، فعاد من جوده الظمآن ريانا. أحيا بحكمته آمال أمته، فعاد من جوده الظمآن ريانا.
His Royal Highness noted the impressive work from Bahrain's writers and poets and their efforts towards enriching Bahraini literary contributions and culture. For his part, Al-Halwaji expressed gratitude for the opportunity to meet His Royal Highness and welcomed His Royal Highness's continued support of the kingdom's cultural and literary heritage. He concluded by reciting one of his poems to His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, the Minister of Interior General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa, and the Minister of Finance and National Economy Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al-Khalifa were present. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa met remotely with the sixth intake of the Prime Minister's Fellowship Program. His Royal Highness highlighted the importance of investing in the Kingdom's citizens to secure sustainable economic development. In this regard, His Royal Highness noted the significant role played by the youth of Bahrain towards realizing the goals of the Kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister further noted the advancing the capability of government employees is a central goal that will be continued throughout all strategic development plans in Bahrain. He went on to highlight the achievements of Bahrain across various government agencies, adding that support will continue to be provided to further enhance their capabilities, which contribute towards the government's overall development. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince congratulated the fellows who were selected following a rigorous evaluation process and wished them success in the year-long program, which aims to further hone their professional development and leadership skills across areas of public service. On this note, His Royal Highness took time to highlight the government's achievements under the leadership of the late His Royal Highness Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa. In this regard, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister emphasized the importance of continuing these efforts to further enhance the performance of the government for the benefit of all. His Royal Highness expressed appreciation to the fellowship's administrators for their commitment to modernize the program's initiatives and ensure the returning fellows apply the knowledge they have retained during the program upon their return to their workplaces. His Royal Highness urged the fellows of the sixth intake to take advantage of the opportunities the fellowship offers and enhance their skills and expertise in order to contribute further to the kingdom's ongoing development. The fellows expressed their gratitude for the opportunity to meet His Royal Highness and expressed their appreciation for his continued support to Bahrain's workforce through various programs and initiatives. They emphasized their commitment and determination to implement the goals of His Royal Highness in order to further enhance the kingdom's progress and development. The National Guard Commander General His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa visited the National Guard Medical Center in Sakhir Camp, which is part of the National Guard Development Project according to the 2020 Strategic Plan. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed inspected the center's facilities and was briefed about its equipment and capabilities. The medical center includes a number of advanced medical departments, a surgical room equipped with advanced medical capabilities and devices, a sterilization room dedicated to preparing the medical staff before entering the operating room, a treatment room for minor surgeries, and a care room for resuscitation and extreme care. The Shura Council held its weekly meeting remotely presided over by its chairman Ali bin Saleh Al-Saleh, where the council discussed a draft law amending Article 1 of the GCC Trademark System Law. The council approved a draft law on Bahrain's joining the multilateral agreement between concerned authorities regarding the exchange of reports between relevant countries, which aims to adopt the necessary regulations and measures for financial reports exchange. The council reviewed a proposal on regulating the activities of sports centers and academies. Following the directives of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa to build 3,000 housing units for the East Sitra housing project and to expedite the delivery of housing services, the Deputy Prime Minister and Chairman of the Ministerial Committee for Development and Infrastructure Projects, Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, announced that construction at the East Sitra housing project has commenced. Sheikh Khalid visited the East Sitra town project to begin construction. He was accompanied by Housing Minister Basim bin Yaqub Al Hamar, also present were the Minister of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning, Assam bin Abdullah Khalaf, Minister of Electricity and Water Affairs, Wael bin Nasser al-Mubarak, Capital Governor Sheikh Hisham bin Abdurrahman, Chinese Ambassador to Bahrain, Anwar Habibullah, MPs, Capital Municipalities, Secretary General and officials from relevant service ministries and government agencies. On the occasion, Sheikh Khalid extended sincere thanks and gratitude to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa for his keenness to meet citizens' aspirations by providing housing services, which is embodied in the government's keenness led by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister to continue implementing the royal order to build 40,000 housing units as reflected in the previous and current government plan. The Deputy Premier asserted that His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister had given orders to begin implementing the 8th housing town in the kingdom, which is added to the national housing gains through the establishment of 3 towns in the previous century, namely Isa, Hamad and Zayed towns, and 4 others over the past 7 years, including Khalifa, Salman, East Hid and Ramli towns. He added that the 4 towns have already been opened and their units are being distributed to beneficiaries. The Deputy Prime Minister stated that the implementation of 5 housing towns simultaneously is a quantum leap in the kingdom's housing sector, noting that the idea of building towns has proved its success in accommodating the citizens' demands and creating modern and socially homogeneous communities. He pointed out that the Ministerial Committee for Development and Infrastructure Projects is closely following up on the implementation of all housing projects through coordination with all the relevant ministries and service government agencies to ensure they are provided with all the necessary facilities and services. For his part, the Housing Minister extended deepest thanks and gratitude to His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, marking the start of construction at the East Sitra Town project, which will reflect positively on their unlimited support for housing services. He affirmed that the Housing Ministry will seek to accelerate the pace of the implementation of the project in cooperation with China Machinery Engineering Corporation to ensure that it is completed according to schedule. The Ministry of Interior issued a statement to clarify facts to the public following misleading media reports. The ministry stated that the visit by UK Home Secretary Priti Patel and her delegation to the Muharraq Police Directorate on December the 6th was on the sidelines of her visit to Bahrain to participate in the Manama dialogue. The ministry was keen to brief the British official on the most successful initiatives and on the outstanding programs on security services in the field of policing, including those performed by the Muharraq Police Directorate through the Family Protection Office, its features and the cases it addressed to ensure the safety of women and children. The visit also covered the Directorate's experience in the programs and practices provided by the community police. The security and safety experiences are also used in the other police directorates across the country. The ministry stressed that relations between Bahrain and the United Kingdom are deep-rooted, extending for over 200 years and are based on clarity and transparency. The statement added that regional stability requires continued close cooperation on common security and counter-terrorism, as well as working closely with UK law enforcement agencies to ensure the security, safety and prosperity of the two peoples. The ministry said that the allegations made by Qatar's Al Jazeera channel about the visit are unfounded and expressed a shock over the misleading media campaign that has intensified recently and aims to undermine Bahrain's human rights reputation and achievements and to harm distinguished relations with the United Kingdom. Bahrain has affirmed that Qatar's false claims that four Bahraini fighter jets violated Qatar's airspace on Wednesday, December 9, 2020 are baseless, unfortunate and unrelated to facts. Bahrain's permanent representative to the United Nations in New York, Jamal Faris Al-Ruwa'i, affirmed in a letter sent to both Security Council President for the month and South Africa's permanent representative to the United Nations, Jerry Matthews Matiola, and the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, that the invalid allegations are unfortunately part of the continuous and escalating distortion practiced by Qatar in order to undermine stability and security, thus increasing regional tensions. The letter added that such practices reflect a lack of credibility and they are contradictory and inconsistent with the principles of good neighborliness stipulated in international conventions to which Qatar claims it adheres. The four aircraft did not enter Qatar's airspace, as the Royal Bahraini Air Force is careful to ensure that it does not cross the borders of other countries. The letter stated that Qatar should instead take note of its continued provocative and hostile behavior, its sponsorship of terrorism and its interference in the internal affairs of neighboring countries, all of which constitute a threat to international peace and security. The letter appealed to the United Nations to take the necessary measures to encourage an end to Qatar's hostile practices and to urge it to respect the UN Charter and deal in good faith with the norms and rules of international law. Bahrain stressed that despite Qatar's false allegations and accusations to divert the international community's attention from its regrettable behavior, the kingdom, based on its deep commitment to the UN Charter, will continue to strive for peaceful solutions in accordance with the international conventions and norms, as well as with the principles of good neighborliness and in line with its keenness on the safety and stability of the region. And the Ministry of Health said today that the number of coronavirus cases reached 1,841, with 174 recoveries, 214 registered new cases, 106 of the new registered cases are expatriates, 91 are contacts of active cases, and 17 are travel-related. The Ministry urges everyone to comply with the guidelines issued by the National Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus.